Class 1 includes the mathematical and physical sciences. Our speaker has drawn on several of these sciences: chemistry, engineering, applied physics, and molecular biology, to conduct pioneering work during more than 25 years on the faculty of the California Institute of Technology. This scientist breeds not plants or animals, but molecules, using synthetic biology to create microorganisms designed to perform new and specialized tasks. Sometimes called directed evolution, the technique has applications in diverse fields such as medicine, alternative energy, and agriculture. Listed as the co-inventor on more than 30 U.S. patents, she has served as science advisor to numerous startup companies. And in 2005, she co-founded Gevo, now a leading renewable chemicals and biofuels company. She is one of only 11 living scientists and the only woman to become a member of the National Academy of Sciences, the National Academy of Engineering, and the Institute of Medicine. Earlier this year, she was awarded engineering's most prestigious honor, the Draper Prize. Among her many achievements, the contribution she is most proud of is her role as teacher and mentor. Quote, "If I can help inspire them to use their remarkable brains to solve important problems and enjoy the process, I feel I've done something really useful," end quote. I am pleased to introduce groundbreaking researcher, inventor, entrepreneur, teacher, and mentor, Dr. Frances Arnold.
Like many of you here today, I was born within just a few years of the discovery of DNA's alpha helical structure. This was a discovery that marked the beginning of a revolution in our understanding of life and how it's evolved. And that scientific revolution, enabled by technology that allowed us to visualize and explain the molecular basis of life itself, has spawned another technological revolution. This biotechnology revolution is moving so quickly that some of us may even live to see life synthesized from non-living material, a new origin of life in the 21st century. Recently, I was asked to lead a conversation on the topic, "What is life?" for the benefit of some Hollywood producers and screenwriters looking for compelling storylines. I am from LA, after all, and believe it or not, scientists are storytellers, too. Like art, pornography, life is not easy to define. We all seem to have some intuition, although not necessarily shared, of what is alive and what is not. And we also admire at least some of its known examples. So in lieu of a definition of life, scientists and philosophers usually make lists of its properties. For example, a living system obtains resources and energy from its environment. It can replicate itself. And most of those lists also include the ability to evolve. These properties have never all been exhibited by a physical system created by man, but that may soon change. We've not yet created life from non-living matter, but we're getting wonderfully, or perhaps to some terrifyingly, close to doing it. In 2010, scientists constructed the first wholly synthetic genome, the entire million base genetic code of a simple bacterium, and used it to replace the genetic code of a closely related organism. And this semi-synthetic cell rebooted, that is, it grew and it reproduced as dictated by its laboratory-generated genome. The technological and scientific advances that enabled this feat have also allowed us to reprogram organisms whose behaviors we would like to control. Now, for thousands of years, human beings have used artificial selection, breeding, to modify everything from corn to carrier pigeons. But recently, just in the last few years, a couple decades, Through genetic engineering, stem cell engineering, or what's known as synthetic biology, humans have built remarkable organisms that can convert renewable biomass to fuels and chemicals, organisms that can track down and annihilate pathogens, cells that can grow into desperately needed tissues and organs, or that could feed the planet's rapidly growing population. Under the pressure of natural selection, nature, life, has created amazing molecules and mechanisms needed for survival in an extraordinary range of conditions. A few billion years of Darwinian exploration, innovation, trial and error, success and failure have generated a truly stunning array of solutions to the problem of being alive. And many of these solutions, often via the DNA that encodes them, can be lifted from the natural context and be used to solve human problems. Compared to any other engineering substrate, you name it, biology surely has the most diverse and creative parts list, but it's also frustratingly unpredictable. We're still woefully ignorant of how to write new DNA code for what we would like an organism to do. But remember, we've only just recently started to try this. For moviegoers, it's easy to tell a gripping story of science or scientists gone bad, the experiments that run amok, the fatal combination of too much power, too little wisdom. It's much harder, much, much harder to write a compelling tale of tragedy that never happened. But that's our job. Scientists are optimists. Why else would we devote so much effort to devising intricate experiments to tease out a little bit of new knowledge? We also continue to innovate, to solve problems, perceived and real. And our world is rife with potential tragedies, rapidly dwindling resources, new diseases that spread with frightening speed, the effects of global warming. And the role of science in protecting our lives and our planet is crucial and dramatic, and the pressure to find those answers is real. In this era of synthetic biology, I hope we'll look to life for inspiration, not just a new opportunity for exploitation. The code of life is rich, like a Beethoven symphony, or the poetry of Whitman. It's intricate, it's elegant, and it is stunningly beautiful. We don't know how to write like that. The best we can do now is copy and paste, maybe rearrange a little bit. But we are learning very quickly. And I hope that the life we write is beautiful, and that it supports, and that it enriches our own. Thank you.